Welcome back to Ask the Expert. Mathew is here. He has three different locations of Ottawa Physiotherapy and Sport Clinic. There's the website right there. You've got one in Barrhaven, Westboro, and in Orleans. Where do you do your thing, or do you travel around all?
I'm kind of in all three of them, but I'm usually at the Orleans.
You're one. In flux.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
Excellent. We're taking a look at the website right here, talking more about running more than anything today. One of the things that you mentioned, Mathew, is that you can see runners all over the place in this city. It's one of the most wonderful things about this city, is the amount of people that get out there and do their thing. But you can quickly identify where there are going to be problems, and that's based on the style of running, is it not?
Pretty much. I think one of the things that you're going to see a lot of, and it's kind of like a new mainstream thing, is forefoot running or midfoot striking, which is really not our new thing. It's just that it's new. It's been brought to attention recently, but that's been happening forever. So a better way of saying this is everybody runs differently.
Yeah.
We have tall people, short people, older, younger, active, non-active, whatever. And there isn't specifically one technique that's going to suit everybody. Everyone's
right.
unique.
Right.
I think that forefoot striking or running in general, we have to be able to adapt the running style to you to get you to do whatever goals you're trying to reach.
Right, right. Now, you do things, as we mentioned earlier, you do things a little differently when it comes to taking runners and identifying issues and so on. You don't go on a treadmill.
Right.
Right? You actually go outside. And there's a huge difference, runners will tell you this, a huge difference between training indoors and outdoors when it comes to running.
Right. Well, on a treadmill, by definition, the machine's helping you run. So a lot of studies will show that your oxygen carrying capacity will increase while you're on a treadmill because you're not working out as hard versus the track. So
Because the treadmill helps you.
Absolutely. It's,
okay.
helping, you, it's
yep.
helping you run. So one of the key things about our scenario is that besides the hour I spend with you in the clinic, 1 hour we're on the track, and in that hour, I'm watching you run, I'm running with you, I'm showing you drills, and we're practicing it for an hour. So that by the time you're done that hour and you run your last lap, you're going to feel that run would have taken you a lot less energy, and you would realize how much more efficient you are relative to the first lap you ran at the beginning of the hour.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah.
So,
like you said to me earlier, you'll be exhausted because you've been working hard for an hour outside on your running technique.
Right.
But there are certain advantages to that down the road, right? Because if you're going to run long distances or in events and so on, being efficient at your running and running properly is a key, right?
Yeah, it's, you know, once you run properly or a little bit more efficiently, whichever term you want to use, you'll notice even within a 5K run, you'll shave a good couple of minutes off easy, and you won't be as tired.
Yeah.
So it's a huge difference.
Right. We're going to get an email question. You guys are at, from EJ. You ready to fire that up? We're going to get an email question. Oh, BJ. Currently training for the Ottawa half. During my long runs, I get a sensation under my gluteal muscle on the left side. It almost feels like a pulled muscle. Is there some way to stretch it out better?
Short answer is yes. I think it kind of depends on what spot you're talking about, because basically in the glutes, there's three muscles. And also, just because you feel a sense of a pull doesn't actually mean it's actually a muscle. It could very easily be a nerve that's being pulled from the low back or anything else.
Right.
So the first thing I would suggest is to get it checked out. By a physio or by a family doctor, just to be safe.
It kind of leads me to this question too. I mean, at what point do you know when you need physiotherapy? Because a lot of people will, first of all, they'll try and whatever activity it is, running is an example, they'll try and train through it, right? And then the problem persists. So they go to a doctor and the doctor can't really do anything except tell you what's wrong. Then you need somebody to work on it. That's where physiotherapy comes in, right?
Essentially. I would agree with you. I mean, even myself, if I'm running and I feel a little bit of a quirk in my leg or whatever, I'm going to ignore it. I think we're all going to do that, especially runners.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So, you know, but I mean, like you said, after a while, whether that be a week or two, if it's getting worse, or after a couple of more weeks after that, you see your family doctor and it's still an issue for you, that's where you start thinking about physio.
Yeah.
Right? And it's always better to do it earlier than later, because usually during race weekend, I'll get an influx of people who are really, really sore with a week left before the race weekend and asking me to fix them. And it's like, well, I'll be able to get you a little bit less pain, but I won't be able to fix it in a week.
Exactly. And that's what this is all about, correcting the problems that exist.
Right.
So you can continue on with the work you're doing. Mathew, thanks for your time. I know you'll be back in a couple of weeks before Tamarack Ottawa race weekend. So we can talk more about people training for that and some other things when it comes to physiotherapy.
Great. Thanks
Good
for
to
having
have you
me.
On the program. make sure you get in touch with Mathew and his team at Ottawa Physiotherapy and Sports Clinics. There are the addresses. They're in Barrhaven, Westboro, and in Orleans. Go to the website to find out more. There's a lot of information on the website that can really help you out if you have issues, be it from running or other sports-related injuries, that's for sure. Get on their website and get in touch. Simple as that. Let's ask the expert. Much more to come here on the program. I believe we got a little bit of yoga going on down the hall here in just a few minutes. We're going to get into that. Some mom yoga for you. We'll be back with that and more right after this. Now just keep on running on.